I feel like I should be at like a USO event or something like that. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today's video is going to be on how to get this look. I was inspired by the 4th of July happening probably today by the time this video gets up, but I decided to film a look that was super patriotic, super bold and blue and red and white, and you know, you could see it. Sorry if my lips look kind of dry, they are, but it's not because of the lipstick, it's just my lips are dry. I don't really know what else to say. Anyway, if you want to see how I got this makeup look, then all you got to do is keep on watching. Okay, so as you can see, I've already started this eye just to kind of see where I was going with this look, but I'm going to do the exact same thing so that they look alike and then go on from there. So I'm starting by priming my eyelid. This is the Milani eyeshadow primer. This is the one that I tend to use. Next, I'm going to use my Too Faced Boudoir Eye Soft and Sexy Eyeshadow Collection. This one right here. And I'm going to take Fuzzy Handcuffs and just put this all over my lid as a base. And then in the same palette, I'm going to use the grayish color called Garter Belt and put that mostly in my crease just to kind of darken it up a little bit. So on this eye, I did use the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Cobalt. It's this really pretty cobalt blue color. And I used it as a base, but you'll see that once I blend out my crease again, it basically just disappears. So I don't know if it's necessary because you'll see I then go in with a different eyeshadow, but just in case it does change the look, I'm gonna just continue to do the same thing that I did on my left eye, on my right. So yeah, I'm just gonna take this and put it all over the lid. And that doesn't have to be neat at all, as you can tell. Going back into this Too Faced palette, I'm going to take Fuzzy Handcuffs again, the like pinky nude shade, and just blend out all of the harsh lines. Okay, so as you can see, a lot of that blue was blended away, so I'm going to go in with the ColourPop Single Pressed Eyeshadow in Two Piece, this really pretty cobalt blue color, and I'm just going to pack that all over the lid. Now that I did this eye is looking a little less smoky, so I'm just going to go back in with both Garter Belt and Fuzzy Handcuffs and try to match them and make this one just a little bit more smokier. Now that those are a bit more even and I've blended out the crease and tried to get rid of any of the harsh lines, I'm just going to take the almost white shade in this palette called In the Buff, right here, and I'm just gonna put that underneath my brow bone. Okay, so part of why I did the eyes before I did all my face makeup was because of all this down here, so I'm just gonna take a makeup wipe and clean up all of that fallout. While I do that, I'm also going to try to make a nice crisp line for when I go in with my eyeliner, which you'll see in a bit. Before I finish the eyes, I'm gonna go in with my base. So for primer, I'm gonna be using the Glam Glow Glow Starter Mega Illuminating Moisturizer in Nude Glow. This guy, you know, we wanna be nice and illuminating for the holiday, so I'm gonna use this, and then I'm going to use my Revlon Colorstay foundation in the shade 150 Buff. This guy. And for concealer, I'm going to be using my Maybelline Fit Me in the shade 15 Fair. So there you go. So I'm just going to do all that and I'll be right back. Okay, so now to finish up the eyes, I'm going to go in with a really nice indigo blue liquid liner. This is by the brand Chella and it is in indigo blue. I definitely just said that. And just look at the tip of this, like. I did notice though that it did dry out pretty quickly, but like, just look at that, like, such a pretty color. So I'm gonna use this as a winged liner, but I don't know, I'm just going with this really. I'm gonna put my e.l.f. makeup remover pen to the test and see how well it does in fixing this wing up. Okay, now that that's done. So as you can tell, this eyeliner was a bit difficult to work with just because it did get kind of dry after keeping the cap off for a little while. And also it is a very similar color to the eyeshadow that I'm wearing, so it doesn't pop as much as I would like it to. So what I decided to do, which I don't even know if I like the way it looks, but I don't know, we'll keep it going. I'm going to put a bit of silver on top. If you have a glittery silver or gold or whatever color you want eyeliner, this would be a great time to use it, but I don't have one, so I figured I would improvise. So I'm going to use my e.l.f. Aqua Beauty cushion palette thing in Cool Mist. If you watch my e.l.f. haul, you'll see I talked about this a bit, but I'm going to use this shade right here. It's the lightest silvery one, or white rather, and I'm going to take a very tiny little eyeliner brush and just wet it a little bit with some setting spray, and I'm going to use that and put it right over the liquid liner. Going to use that same color and just use that in the inner corners of my eyes. For the bottom lash line, I'm going to use that first gray color in the Too Faced palette, and with a detail brush I'm going to just put that all along the lower lash line. Okay, and then using the ColourPop blue eyeshadow, I'm going to put that right against my waterline. Okay, so this is when I improvised again. So if you have like a white or a cream eyeliner, I would line your waterline using that, but it's something that I thought that I had, but I don't. So instead, I'm gonna use that light shade in the Too Faced palette to serve as an eyeliner and just kind of brighten up my eyes and kind of make them look a little bit bigger and more open. Also, sorry if this like weirds anyone out because I'm going literally on my waterline. Now I'm just gonna highlight using a shimmery shade underneath my brow bone. For mascara, I'm gonna be using this new mascara that a few of my friends very graciously gave to me. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise. I'm super excited to try this. I've heard tons of people rave about it. I have high hopes, so let's see. Whoa. See, I think if I look to the side, oh my god, look how voluminous those look. Oh my god. I'm so impressed. Eyelash curler definitely helps because I forgot to curl these ones. So, but even so, like if I turn this way, like, oh my god. This might be my new favorite mascara, if I'm being honest. Put a little on the lower lashes. Okay, so now for the rest of my face, I'm going to start with my contour. I'm gonna be using the highlight and contour palette by IBY Beauty. I think I got this in a BoxyCharm, I believe. It comes with 3 highlighters and 3 contour shades. So I'm gonna be using the contour number 1 in here. It's a really pretty, like cool toned contour shade. I just want to bronze the face up a little bit more so that I don't look so scary. So for that, I'm going to be using the Tarte bronzer in Park Avenue Princess. This is what it looks like. And I'm just going to put that everywhere, really. Then for blush, I'm going to be using this one by Laura Geller. It is in the shade Tropic Hues. It's a super pretty baked blush. And honestly, I don't know why I don't use this more often, but I'm just going to swatch it for you. Like, it's a super pretty, like peachy coral toned color. And I feel like at first it's kind of intimidating, but if you go in with a light hand, it's like a really pretty color. So that's what I'm gonna do. For highlighter, I'm gonna be using my Ofra highlighter in Rodeo Drive. When mine came, it was kind of broken, but it still works just fine, so still gonna use it. Oh. Forgotten how pigmented that was because, do you see this? It's okay, we're gonna blend it out. Should probably. Oh my god. The whole side of my cheek is so bright. Okay, it looks like I was able to blend some of that out because that was some bright highlight. Finally, the lip. So if you want this to be a more wearable look, or if you don't want to be too crazy with your lip, you can totally go in with like a nice neutral, you know, nudie color. But I figured, you know, for the 4th of July, if we want to be all patriotic and whatnot, why not just go all out, or mostly just for this video. Instead of doing that really pretty nude, which you could totally do, I'm going to be using a nice red, like red. Like this is red. This is by Ciate, and it is their London Liquid Velvet in the shade Diva. This is the finished look. It is definitely very bold, but you know what? like, go for it. It's time to celebrate. Definitely a fun look that I enjoyed creating. And maybe if you were looking for something to wear for the 4th of July or, you know, just a summer party coming up and you wanted a nice bold blue eye look, then I hope that you, I don't know, could use this or that this is useful to you in some way. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it very much if you liked and subscribed to my channel below. Please comment for any additional ideas for videos that you would like me to do in the future. And I will see you in my next video. Bye. Whoops, forgot to set everything. America.